In this video, I'll show you how to export subtitles and captions from Sonix.ai. Hi, my name is David, and if this is your first time watching, kindly consider liking this video and sharing it with your friends if you get any value from this content. Now, the reason why I'm doing this video is because exporting a subtitle is easy, but sometimes you need to export the subtitle with the right settings. So, once you're done automatically transcribing your audio or video inside Sonix, and you've made your edits to the text and ensuring that the punctuation is correct, the words are what they need to be in your particular transcript, then you'll need to navigate to the export tab. Now, the export tab allows you to export your transcript in different formats. And if we click on it, we're going to be to get this particular prompt where we need to choose a file format. For the purposes of this video, we're going to choose subrip subtitle file, which is an SRT, or the web VTT, that is a .vtt. These are closely related subtitle files, but this web VTT allows for styling and all that. But let's just click on subrip. And once we click on subrip, there are different options that we need to select. So, do you want to show speaker names? If you don't want to show speaker names, or if your audio or video only has one speaker, then just let it remain as no speaker names available. If you want to show speaker names, just ensure they're available. And if you want to show the speaker names and with an uppercase, that is an option as well if you have different speakers for your audio or video file. But let's just leave it as no, hide the speaker names, and then you need to know how many lines you need to put. A good subtitle file has a maximum of about 2 lines. The reason why you do 2 lines is to ensure that the subtitle is easily readable without so much fuss. But there are 3 options here. Keep subtitle as a single line. That might end up being too fast depending on the characters that you have per line. Secondly, the split subtitle over 2 lines is usually the best, and also capped with a good number of characters per line. That will make the subtitles easily readable to the eye. If you split the subtitles over 3 lines, that might be too much text for somebody to read through, and they might not enjoy the content that you have. So let's leave it at split subtitle over 2 lines. And once you do that, there is also a maximum time duration per subtitle. And by default, the maximum is 10 seconds. Now, from experience, a subtitle file should be between 1 second and 8 seconds. Now, basically, that gives enough time for somebody to have read the particular subtitle. So, depending on who is watching, a child or somebody who is in a busy area, you need to set the maximum amount of time that you can have per subtitle. I prefer to bring this down to 8. Let's leave it at 8 seconds. And then, for the maximum characters length per line, that is, if we have 2 lines, then how many characters, including spaces, would we want to have for a subtitle? Personally, I work with between 32 to 42, but my sweet spot is 37 characters per line. So I'll just bring this down to about 37. And that is good. That is all that I need to set up inside here. I won't work with any paragraph breaks here, but let's just say that is all we wanted to do to export our SRT file from Sonix. Just click on download export, and it's going to prepare our export. Now, once it's done, it's going to automatically download onto a computer as an SRT subtitle file. So let's just give it like 1 second or two, and it's going to be done with the export, and the file is going to automatically download. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click on it. And if I open it up, this is what it looks like. It looks short and easy. Mostly when you work with like 37 characters, they only pass your time codes by just some few lines. If you work with 32, potentially they just stop at this particular section, and we can actually just do that real quick. Let's say SRT. Since we've already set, let's say we want to leave it at 32. Let's say 32, which is more or less what is used for broadcast. And then just click on download, so that we can easily compare the 2 subtitles. So this is the original one, and then we can just click on the new one, and you see what I'm mentioning. It's almost, this is the new one, and this is the one that we worked with initially. So you can see what I mean. This one is smaller and looks easily readable than this one, but somewhere between 32 and 42 is a sweet spot when it comes to having the characters per line. But basically, that is how you can export a subtitle file in SRT format from Sonix.ai. I hope that this video has been of value and that you're going to try it out so that you can see if it's going to work for you in your subtitling and all that you want to do. Thank you for watching this video. Until next time, stay safe and never stop learning. Thank you for watching this video.